Across California, the new school year will begin in August, but it will not be learning as usual. In some school districts, including Los Angeles, it will be in the form of distance learning.
Reopening schools will significantly increase the interaction between children and adults from different families. A 10-year-old student might have a 30-year-old teacher, a 50-year-old bus driver, or live with a 70-year-old grandmother. All need to be protected. There's a public health imperative to keep schools from becoming a petri dish.
Los Angeles County has recently seen a significant surge in the number of COVID-19 cases, setting multiple records of highest daily infections and hospitalization rates.
My concern as a parent is my own children's health and well-being. And as a teacher, of course, I was worried about my students as well, because many of them live with multiple families and they don't have access to health insurance. And, you know, it's being that the communities that we serve in LA Unified are mainly Hispanic, African-American, low-income families. And they're the ones that are highest at risk right now.
But in nearby Orange County, where recent Trump rallies were held in protest over closures, the decision by some school districts to open schools as normal was welcomed by many.
No masks, no social, I don't even call it that, forced distancing, no plexiglass, no walking on arrows in one direction and another. They issued a statement saying that school would be opened as normal.
Meanwhile, colleges took their own decisions on how to proceed with the fall semester. California State University, the largest four-year university system in the nation, will mandate students to take classes online, while other institutions are looking toward a partial reopening.
President Trump has been calling for schools to open for all students, and in fact, his administration had asked international students to leave the country if they were not taking in-person classes. But after a court challenge, the policy has been scrapped. The question of how long schools should continue with online education still remains a divisive issue among some parents, teachers, and politicians. It is Tian Shan, CGTN, Los Angeles.